Welcome into Better and Green. We're going to give you the picks to win some money today. But first, we wanted to let you guys know, head over to bettergreen.com. Right now, we are having three subscription tiers, $1, $5, and $10. That is how you can get our premium plays. The $1, that's only $12 a year. We'll get you all of our weekly plays for the entire year. The other tiers, really cool. Also, they got a bunch of other stuff. Go check those out on bettergreen.com, better bettorgreen.com. We got a bunch. We got weekly pick'ems. We got two survivor pools over there. One, I believe, if we get everybody in, $450. Correct, Wyatt?
Correct.
And then the other two, ESPN's giving away $117,000. So if you guys want some more money to place on these bets, head over there, bettergreen.com. Wyatt, let's start with you today, man.
Yeah, so please tune into our video tomorrow because we have way more in depth of college football. But college football is back. Of course, I have to add some of those plays into my big three. I don't want to spoil too many of the plays for next week or for next episode. But I do have two college football plays that I will be taking. And the first one is actually in Ireland. It is Navy Notre Dame. They play Saturday at 2:30. It's the first game kickoff of the college football season. Of course, we have to bet it. I've bounced all over this line like every single day this week. And I came to the conclusion that I'm going to take the over of 49 points in this game. It's actually dropped some, I think it opened at 51.5. So it's probably a little square, but thought process here is I was really heavy on the under. Navy new, offense or new coach, new offensive coordinator, Notre Dame, another great quarterback transfer in Sam Hartman. He's a 6-year. I don't even know how that's possible. But I was expecting the travel and the time change and the weather of Ireland, Dublin, Ireland, to play effect on this total. But the more I'm looking at it, I just can't see this game going under. I'm going to take the over as my first bet of the college football 2023 season.
Well, that talked me off the under because I also was looking under military academy, hard not to. But I think, you know, it's such a big spread, 20.5 there, Notre Dame. I'm assuming you're thinking puts up a big chunk of the points there, probably names their score. Yeah, don't hate that. Kind of takes me off the under. But I'm going back to the well for the third week in a row, looking at the Detroit Lions. But this time I'm not playing on them. I'm playing the total in the game. And it's I will make this an actual play for myself. I've only bet one preseason game thus far, but I will be betting this. I'm taking the under 37 in this game. Shop around a little bit. You can probably get a 37.5. Don't think there's anything higher than that right now, but for the show, it'll be under 37 minus 110. Biggest reasoning here, Carolina's played a pretty bland style of preseason football. They've not been good. They haven't really run their regular season packages. They're kind of just going out there, throwing Bryce out there and saying, hey, just get some NFL experience, but not trying to show much. Detroit has looked okay. They really didn't look great this past game, only put up 7 points. Teddy Bridgewater struggled. I think he plays a little bit deeper into this game, but not going to be a ton of urgency out of him, obviously an NFL vet. And the biggest reason for liking this bet is these guys play in the regular season, early October. So about a month and a half from now. So I don't think they're going to have any urgency to show anything to each other. I think it's going to be very boring, bland, vanilla. So I think under 37 is going to be the play here. I think it's probably sharp. Money has come in on it early. It was 38.5, I think, at the open. But still like it at 37. I think it's going to be low scoring, boring, final preseason game.
Absolutely. Hey, I saw too many Lions hats, so I had to throw my hat on. It's too blue in here.
I saw you doing that. I was wondering what was happening.
You
were gearing up for a Chiefs play.
Oh, that's coming. That is coming, oh, okay. Baby. But I felt a little outnumbered there. I had to get back into the game a little bit. I'm taking the Eagles -5 at -110 versus Indy. This was a Super Bowl team, and they're getting 5 points versus a team that has been dealing with a lot of dysfunction this offseason. Right now we're wondering, is Jonathan Taylor going to get traded? I know a couple teams have been putting out feelers, and it looks like a couple have even submitted offers for him. I don't believe it's like 2 or 3. So there's a lot going on in Indy. Don't think that everybody's mind is probably where it's supposed to be. I think by week 1, they'll get there, but this is preseason. There's a lot going on, and you get 5 points with the Super Bowl runner-ups, Marcus Mariota. I think that their team is very good, so we're going to go with the Eagles plus 5.
Yeah, also, hopefully Mariota doesn't play a whole lot because he sucked last week and ruined my bet. But I forget He's who back. Came in after him, but he played unreal in the second half of that that game last week. Also, didn't Trent Richardson get punched in the face by one of his teammates? I think that came out like on Monday or Tuesday. They got in a fight and a guy threw a punch or something. The Colts are kind of a dumpster fire.
Yeah.
Oh, Anthony Richardson.
Sorry, yeah, Anthony Richardson. Who did I say?
Okay. You said Trent. I was like, wait a minute, that guy still plays.
He's back.
No. Anthony, sorry. Anthony Richardson. Got punched in the face by like a D lineman or something, or punched in the helmet, whatever. You usually don't do that to your
Geno Smith treatment.
Yeah.
Made him into the man he is today.
Yeah.
Joke.
Anthony Richardson season is going to be crazy this year. Anyways, going back to college football, I have one more college football play before I get into my third and final play, which is also not baseball. I'm going to take New Mexico State -6.5 against UMass. I'm not going to get too into depth on this episode, but New Mexico State had one of their best seasons ever last year, going 7-5. I know, crazy. But wow. This team has a lot of momentum. They have a new – their coach is getting their boys ready. This used to be one of the worst teams of the FBS. And then, obviously, 7-5, they made it to a bowl game, won their bowl game. Now playing at home against UMass. UMass has three wins the past three seasons combined. So they have one win each of those years. And actually, I think 4 seasons ago, they went winless. So 3 wins in 4 years for UMass. They do have a Clemson quarterback transfer, I guess, who then transferred to Georgia Tech, who then is now transferring to UMass. So that just means he sucks and was a total wrong recruit and a bust. This line's also dropping heavy in favor of UMass. So this is probably another square play. But unlike the MLB, you just got to trust your gut in college football. Can't worry about the trap lines too much. Just trust your gut. And usually that's better than guessing in the MLB. But I like New Mexico State -6.5. I think that is so obvious, but it's so I can't see that losing.
Yeah, I definitely lean that way too. I actually follow UMass quite a bit because my buddy is a coach for them. So I can't go against UMass, but
they're not good.
it's rare that they have a single digit spread. I'll say that. Even though New Mexico State is probably not that far behind, but I will also look for my first college football bet of the season here. I won't get too deep into it. Watch Friday's show. We're diving into all these games. But I'm going to take Ohio plus the 2.5 -108. I think Ohio's a live dog on the road at San Diego State in this one. There is 67% of the bet coming in on San Diego State. However, this line went from +4 to +2.5. So I think sharps are all over Ohio. I think Ohio wins outright. I will follow the sharps here. I'll take the +2.5. I think they went out right, but I'll play it safe.
Like it, man. I'm going to take the Chiefs money line. Make my first Chiefs play of the year. They're at plus money. They're at +118 versus the Browns. Chiefs, for people that don't know, obviously there is a quarterback competition going. Everybody knows that. No, not for the starter role, but for the backup role. Bukley is how I say his name. It's probably not how it's pronounced, but he was 21 of 28 for 260 yards and 2 touchdowns so far in the preseason, whereas Gabbert, 11 of 16, 179 yards and 3 touchdowns. I believe Gabbert he hit every pass the last game. I think he had a perfect passer rating, 158.3. Like, dude's been balling out. A lot of receivers are competing, too, to play with Patrick Mahomes, and there is no, like, Tyreek Hill, big-name guys. You got MVS as pretty much a lock to make the roster, but then you got a bunch of Richie James, Sky Moore, Rashee Rice, Justin Ross. I forget the guy's name in the Saints game, but the dude was balling out too. All these guys are going to be competing, so this game means a lot for all these backup players. So I'm going to take them at the money line at +118.
I love it. They're +150 on DraftKings, so make sure you're getting the right odds on that, but I love it. Beautiful. My third and final play is going to be in the NFL preseason, and I'm going to take the Bengals Commanders under 37. You would have thought the Commanders just won the Super Bowl after snapping yes. the Ravens streak. They played their starters the entirety of the first half. I believe Dotson got hurt, or not Dotson.
Terry
got hurt. Sam Howell got beat around, but and like they played everyone for the first 30 minutes of that game. They're not going to do that again. The Bengals also are terrible in the preseason. They've tied 13-13, and they lost week one to the Packers 36-19. So Bengals have nothing to play for. Commanders, if they play their starters again, they're stupid. So this is going to be a super low scoring game. I don't really see it getting into the 20s. I think it's going to be like 13-6 or something like that. So I'm going to go with the under in that.
Yeah, if it wasn't bad enough that Joey Sly has himself tattooed on his arm in a Panthers uniform who he kicked for like two seasons. But then he has to go running around like he just kicked them to a Super Bowl like 49 yards.
Yeah, gave him the L.
In a
embarrassing, dude.
In a week two preseason game. So bad luck, Mr. Sly. But as your ink shows, you don't maybe make the greatest decisions all the time. But I digress. I was looking to play Cincy in this game for Wyatt's similar reasons. Washington literally looked like they won the Super Bowl, but I'm not impressed with Cincy, so I do like that underplay. I'm going back to preseason football here. I'm going to take the Giants +6. This line, I literally took like a 30-minute nap before we hopped on, and when I fell asleep, this was -4.5 for the Jets. It's now -6. So I assume others like myself watched Hard Knocks and they saw Saleh saying everyone's suiting up, Rodgers is playing, he wants to win this game, blah, 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 blah. I think it's just some Hard Knocks hype, to be honest with you. Rodgers obviously is not playing many snaps. He might get a drive or two. Just think it's too many points. This is a unique game since they share a home stadium. Giants are technically home, but I think there will be a little, I don't know, extra oomph to this game just for, you know, who owns the Meadowlands at this in this preseason game, if you will. So I just think +6, you're probably going against the public here. You're going against the Hard Knocks hype. Just think it's too many points. So I'll take the +6 with the Giants.
Love that, man. Love that. I'm going to take the last one, Houston, New Orleans, over 38. So I'm thinking over 38 because C.J. Stroud has not looked good in the preseason, and we are running out of time. The regular season is right around the corner. You need to get him playing as much as possible. You need to get some touchdowns out of him. Definitely get some drives out of him. So he's going to be playing, I'm thinking, at least the whole first half. I could see him playing the whole game because this dude needs work. I don't know if it's – I mean, I know it's not smart.
He can't read.
Exactly. He can't read. He can't read a book, let alone defenses. So I worry about that. And then you also have Jameis Winston, the backup for the Saints, playing against the second-string Texans defense, which does not instill fear in anybody. So I think that this game could soar.
Love it. Love it. I despise CJ Stroud. I hope he has the worst career of his life, and I hope he's one and done. So yeah, we'll see. I could do the over. I don't know if he's gonna be able to score, but I'll do the over for sure.
I think he will have the worst career of his life. Probably the worst, the best.
And he's the only Ohio State quarterback that hasn't beat Michigan in the last 30 years. So
yeah.
Dude sucks.
Off to a bad start.
He's just a loser.
Off to a bad start.
He loses the big game, so watch out for this preseason week 3.
True.
You guys got anything else before we get out of here?
Exciting times. So hopefully we can we're starting to see some traction on some of our videos, some of our lives, and hoping that this continues for the football season. And we made it through the long and barren summer, but ready to be back.
Yeah, a week from right now, my big three will almost certainly be all week one college football. I cannot wait. Might throw a little NFL in there. That might be 2 weeks out, though, for my big three. We'll see. But, yeah, we are it's go time. Football is really actually here.
All right, guys, well, that's going to do it for us here at Better and Green. Make sure you guys head over to bettergreen.com. Consider subscribing over there. Consider subscribing here. You guys need to get on this action. We're donating $1 for every subscriber we have until kickoff to St. Jude. So make sure you guys get in on that. And besides that, we're back on Friday. We'll see you guys then.
See you Friday, boys.
See you guys.
You better start listening to the Better in Green podcast. You will not regret it. Trust me, trust me, trust me. And hey, I'm Dean Blandino.
Welcome, welcome, welcome to Better in Green, eh? To Better in Green, eh? To Better in Green, eh? Listen in and cash out. That's what it's all about. Come on, let's make cash now. We always on spot and we cover old spot from the bottom to the top, eh? Shout out to Ethan, shout out to Wyatt, shout out to Ben. Welcome, welcome to our podcast, Better in Green.